Okay, let's talk about another amazing function within Final Cut Pro 10. Final Cut Pro 10 has the ability to detect people within a specific shot. You can tell Final Cut Pro to find areas of people within an entire event or within individual clips. If you attempt to find people for an entire event, the process may take a while, depending on the amount of media that Final Cut Pro has to analyze. For this demonstration, I'll select just two clips within the event browser, so you can see how the process works. By the way, to select more than one clip, just hold down the Shift key when selecting an additional clip segment. Right-click on the selected clips within the event browser and choose Analyze and Fix from the contextual menu. You will see there are several options to choose from. Click on the option to find people. Click the OK button and Final Cut Pro 10 will begin its analysis. You can view the progress by clicking here to show the background tasks window. Don't worry, if you have a large group of clips that are being analyzed, you can continue working until the analysis is completed. When the analysis is done, you will find a purple line representing areas where Final Cut Pro detects people. Now granted, the process is never perfect, but I find it suitable enough to give you a good idea of whether a shot contains people or not. Let's first take a look at our dancing Jamaican in the event browser window. If I twirl down this disclosure triangle, you will see that Final Cut Pro has tagged an area that it detects as one person, medium shot. Wow, I would say that's fairly accurate. Now granted, there's an area that it missed tagging here. But the idea is to give you a head start when it comes time to organizing your footage. Okay, so now let's take a look at the clip called Dip in the Pool. What's amazing is that Final Cut Pro attempts to distinguish between one person, two persons, or a group of people. It also detects whether a clip is a close-up, a medium shot, or a wide shot. You'll notice that this clip has two different keywords representing two persons and one person. Both areas are also detected as a wide shot. But wait, how can this be? There's definitely two people throughout the entire clip. Well, let's see. So here's what happened. If I skim through the last part of the clip, the guy puts his body underwater, and Final Cut Pro suddenly detects there's only one person. Therefore, you end up with two keywords for the same clip. You can fix this by deleting that particular keyword. If you decide to delete the keyword analysis for a section of a clip, just right-click on the keyword and choose Remove Analysis Keywords. That brings me to my next point. I'm going to right-click on the clip again and choose Analyze and Fix from the contextual menu. This time I'm going to choose Consolidate Find People Results. This feature will consolidate all the keywords into the most common shot type within each 2-minute time frame. This will help eliminate areas where Final Cut Pro 10 misinterprets the footage content. I recommend using the consolidate feature unless you have clips that have a very long duration. You should now have the basics for analyzing shots with people.